on the freeway right now. Today is November 2nd, 2015. I am secretly on my way to jury duty. And while I don't agree with keeping secrets from your spouse, on Wednesday I was fed up with my husband's attitude towards my decision to answer my jury duty summons. It was my decision to open the envelope, my decision to go to the internet, my decision to log in and find out more about this jury duty summons. They said on the internet that I need to call on the evening of the 27th of October to see if I need to go to jury duty or not. I called on the evening of the 27th. They said I did. I went to jury duty on the 28th, and my husband said it was the stupidest thing I've ever could have done. And again, like I said, while I don't agree with hiding things from your spouse, I also don't agree with belittling your spouse's decision to answer her jury duty summons. And that's what I feel like. I feel like if
in 2 miles, take exit 199B for Jefferson Street.
I feel like my husband belittled me, made me feel stupid, tried to make me feel like I am making a poor decision. And I didn't want his opinion about the justice system to cloud my opinion for this jury, for this trial. As a juror, I need to have as little influence from the outward public as possible. So I chose not to tell my husband that I have jury duty this week and all week long, and I'm not sure I'm ever going to tell him, just because I don't need to hear it from him. He's nothing but a negative influence on me when it comes to something he doesn't agree with. If he agrees with it, then he's fine. But if he doesn't agree with it, then he is terrible. And he puts me in a panic attack, anxiety. I choose to lie rather than have to deal with those emotions.
In a half mile, take exit 199B for Jefferson Street.
I choose to hide things from him rather than deal with the truth with him. And while my therapist says I need to...